What starts to move, take about 3 or 4 games, actually. That's usually good after. Good boy.
Come on down here, man. Today, what we're gonna do, we're gonna talk about diagonal. Some of you guys have seen this already. Some of the drills we're gonna do today, are gonna be a little different. Be similar but different. That make sense? No? Okay. What I mean by that is they're gonna have to do, one is the hand-eye coordination drill that we can do. We're all kind of blessed with a certain amount of hand-eye coordination, but it is something that we can improve as we work at. You only need a certain amount of hand-eye coordination in order to be a pretty good hitter.
Who's seen this before? Some of you guys have seen this before.
Most of you guys have seen this before? Okay. Do you know what this is? Who can tell me what that is? I don't hear it. What is it, baby?
It's like the zones where you need to swing the ball when you hit.
Yeah. Exactly right. What we call this, boys, we call this a hitting diagonal. And you all know what diagonal is, right? Cross. Okay? Vertical, horizontal, diagonal. And the page is exactly right. What this is where we need to let the ball, or we say the ball travel, each of these points, to be able to do some damage with the baseball. And we need to do some damage with it, that means it's hit with the forward, drive the baseball. How it's set up, and this is how it's set up to where when I got in my stance, okay, when I get in the batter's box, normally, now everybody's going to be a little different, so the diagonal may be a little further out, or maybe a little further back, according to where you stand in the batter's box. But what I always did, boys, is I always went to the back of the batter's box, and I tried to scratch out the back, but I wanted to give myself as much distance from the pitcher to home plate, and even to the catcher. I want to give myself the longest amount of time possible to see the ball. Okay? So I didn't stand in front of the box, that shortened the distance, and I stood way back here. My back foot would be on the back side, and that would usually leave my front foot coming off of this corner of the plate. So it would be the back corner of the plate, right off here. So that would be, my diagonal would be set up as so. This is what an inside pitch would be. Where I make contact with it, this is where I make contact with the pitch down the middle, and this is where I make contact with the pitch on the outer half or away from it. I have to be able to drive all three of these pitches to be an effective hitter. And to be an effective hitter, to do some damage, hit with power. You guys heard me say the word power before, what does that mean? What does that mean? Does that mean home run? Hit the ball or trend? Means driving the ball. Who knows what slugging percentage is? Just heard that term before. Guys, just raise your hand. You don't have to all shout at once. You maintain or don't get too excited, okay? Slugging percentage, boys, is any of our extra base hits. Doubles, triples, home runs. And in order to higher slugging percentage is generally an indicator of power. Not saying that it tells you how much you have and how much you don't have, but it generally tells you where you are. We want to be able to have what we call power off field. We want to be able to drive the ball. From a left-handed hitter, I want to be able to drive the ball right field. At full field, which you should pretty much be able to. But I want to be able to drive the ball left field. Not just pull the ball out. Same thing if I'm right-handed. I want to be able to drive the ball right center as well as I drive the ball right. That should be our goal. So, what the diagonal is, right off my inside toe, okay, my front foot, corner of the plate, when I land, and I take my stride, okay, take my stride, remember a stride is climbing mechanism, you guys have heard this now, and I start my turn. Now I get the diagonal, the most important what I do with my lower half, okay, my hands don't move until my lower half is in line with this ball and diagonal. So what I have to do to get this fixed, I have time your barrel will come out and get out outside your hand, but get outside of the plate, or I make contact, and I try to keep the ball fair. Ball it down the middle of the plate. When I land and I swing, ball it down the middle of the plate, and almost right off my big toe. Right here. Again. I have to turn my lower half, get in position. Once my lower half is turned, then I can drive a baseball. This is poised where I'm making contact, my back gets to extension, arms are extended, and I drive the ball right in the middle. Now the ball is further away from me. Ball that I have hit the opposite field. I let that ball travel to where I stride, and it's not even a full turn or half turn, it's barely a quarter turn. Belly button gets lined up to this baseball. Then my hands go. I make contact with this ball. My lower half is still rotating. My upper half catches up. And I stay down through it. And I drive the ball out to the field. Most common mistakes I see with young hitters is they don't let this pitch or anything on this half of the plate get to this point. Okay? They make contact with it out here. If I hit this pitch out here, or even worse, this pitch out here, what's going to happen, boys, is you're going to smother the ball into the ground. And usually, if I'm left-handed, I'm going to hit the ball to second baseman. If I'm right-handed, I'm going to hit the ball to shortstop, maybe third baseman. So you have to have a discipline to let the ball travel. And you all heard the term, let the ball get deep. You've heard me say it a million times. Some of you guys have been around me for a while now. Let the ball travel. Let the ball get deep. Trust your hands. Okay? Trust your hands. They're a lot quicker than you do credit for. But in order for us to hit these pitches with any power or any authority, we've got to let the ball travel. We've got to let the ball travel. Okay? So, no jazz left-handed. Everybody else is ready. Correct? Okay? So, when we set up, we do the drill. And that's what this drill is going to be. On this, right here, boys, we're going to use the T today. What we're going to use the T, we're going to use it to hit the ball to the opposite field. Now, this piece is a little different, fellas, because it's got a weight, and so it's tougher to move around the plate. And what I mean by that is if I'm right-handed and I try to put it on the outside corner, see how it kind of leans on the side like that? Okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up the tee where it can stay flat. Okay, it's going to be on the outer half, and I won't be able to get it to the corner. So what I'm going to do for this drill, okay, you're going to partner up. We're going twos. We're going to do our rotation, okay, as far as the swing and the rotation. Excuse me, and then we're going to do live at the end. Only four guys are going to be allowed to live swings today, which is always nice, right? Okay? Come on around here, boys. Let me get right here. Just because my left hand is going to be good. Sometimes it is, but most of the time it's not. So, when I said this tee is going to have to stay kind of in the middle of the plate so it doesn't fall off or slide around, what that means is I set up to this ball as I would if I'm trying to hit the ball to the opposite field. Okay, obviously, Chad, you're to left center. All the righties are to right center. And for me, setting up to hit the ball the opposite field, is I set that ball up to where it's just off of my, if I'm right-handed, it's off my left groin. If I'm left-handed, it's off my right groin. I gotta let the ball travel this far in order to make contact. Don't set up to, as you would, this looks like it's down the middle of the plate, and try to chicken wing and push it that way. We want to drive the ball right here. So I set up to it. We're just off of my right groin, right here. Now you guys remember the T drill. We introduced it last week, what we do. We still pick up the pitcher. We still track the ball into our hitting zone, okay? Track the ball into our hitting zone. My front foot lands. Then I pick up the baseball. You all remember that? Remember we talked about that last week, okay? So here, land, pick up the baseball, start my just my quarter turn, and then keep my hands inside, and hit this ball off to the opposite field. Here, land, pick up the ball, drive the ball the other way. Now, I'll take that chance. You guys notice what I do with my front arm? Another common thing that young hitters do incorrectly when we're trying to hit the ball the opposite way.
is that they'll push their front elbow forward, and then they'll push with their hands out this way. Okay, and this is what we call a chicken wing. I'm chicken winging the ball. I'm just floating the ball out to the opposite field. I don't want to float the ball. I want to drive the ball. Correct? I don't want to float it out there. I want to try to see if I can hit it over a fence that way. When I get here, land. I start my turn. My front side stays tight. Okay, my arms stay tight. I start my lower half, and then I let my hands work. Here, land. Drive the ball the other way. When you get to contact, boys, you shouldn't see any space in your front arm and your side. Okay? Make sense? Here, land, stay inside, drive the ball the opposite gap. T-drill. We all remember how to do that. Right? Don't need a triple refresher course. Just a double refresher course will do it. Okay? Now, down here, boys. Come on down with me. Now, remember, boys, when we do these, okay, we take about 7 to 10 swings, and then we switch. Not switch between drills, but switch in your partner. Switch with your partner. Who's ready? Want to try it? Okay? This is going to be the hand-eye drill, boys. Now, if you feel more comfortable, start with your bat, you can start with your bat. That's fine. If you want to work your way to the stick, fine too. What we're going to do is we're going to hit the ball towards a concrete ball off this net. I'll show you why. Because what we're going to do today is we're going to introduce it to some of these little golf balls. Okay, a little golf ball with the ball. And this is a drill I did a lot. I should say we did a lot when we were your guys' age with my brothers down in the basement. We made games out of it. We didn't have a fancy stick like that, though. We had an old pipe that we used for when we redid the plumbing in our house and real heavy. But we used to hit with the smaller surface, and then we hit balls that are about this size. Okay, again, this is a hand-eye drill. So, what we're going to do is we're going to do our soft toss. We all remember that. We cover that again the first couple weeks. You boys notice all these drills go off of the drills that we learned earlier. Okay, so there's a reason that we started these drills, because we're kind of building up and we're getting a little more advanced. We can do some of these drills with you guys that we won't be able to do with the 10-year-olds, because they're a little tougher for those guys right now. You guys are a little older, a little more advanced, so we can do some of these. Okay? So, soft toss. Remember, line up. Front side, right off the tape, front leg. Start with my hand, tiny, wing. Ready? High ball. Back, through, good. Now, that stick's probably about half the weight of what your guys' bats are. So before you jump in, you may want to take a few bats and get used to the weight. Or if you want to start with your back, that's fine too. It feels like a toothpick, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Down, back, boom. What I would suggest, boys, when you guys are going through, especially if you're going through your first round, take 5 to 10. If you're going to use a stick, take 5 to 10 in your first round with the big one. Okay? With the big ball. Now, once you get ready for this, babe? Okay, we'll give it a shot. Now again, if these are tough to hit with the stick, use your bat to start. Okay? I'm more worried about quality swings compared to quantity. So if now I'm at the surface and I'm doing a juggling act as far as firing these balls at my partner, I'm making sure that he's getting ready, he's getting set to get off a good swing. Now, this is where our hand-eye coordination stuff comes into play. It's a little tougher to do. My baby did a nice job there squishing the bug. Don't break down mechanically just because the ball's smaller or because the bat's smaller. The mechanics stay the same. Very nice. Now the reason why they're hitting towards the concrete wall, for that reason alone, is we don't want to have you chasing the golf ball all the way back into the parts department. Well, the wall will keep it kind of close. There you go. Maintain. Low stride, bingo. Good. Good. Good, baby. So, there's a regular baseball size in here, boys, and there's a golf ball size in here as well. Okay, I would suggest first round, you want to start with the stick, use a baseball size, hit about 10, pick them up, let your partner hit 10. Then you can work your way into the golf ball side of football. There's a whole mess of these in here too. Hit about 10,
partner hits tenth. We're having a hard time if we can't maintain our mechanics with the smaller bat because we're trying so hard to hit it. Let's use our regular bat until we get the feel of it. Make sense? Okay?
Let's roll these in here quick, bud.
Now, you partner up, boys. Okay, partner up. We got two groups. We're going to be two rotations. The first group starts here. Okay? With the ball with the small bat. The second group will come down here with the tee.
Thank you.
whole mess of them.
Suppose it's easier to pick one.
Short, fan, driver,
and inside.
All right, take your turn.
What?
Want me to feed you?
Swish that butt. Swing comes through fantastic. I'll leave that up. on the table, but that's saying that's not your deal. You know what I mean? I have to move your legs.
Thank you.